Oh, hello everyone. I'm Deborah Tannen, and welcome to a special on-the-road edition of a Let's Go Tannin with Deborah Tannen, where I, Deborah Tannen, will be visiting an unsuspecting family to help them sort out their issues. Of course, I'll be using the aid of my possible world-renowned book, You're Wearing That, to dig deep into the psyches of these poor souls. Today, we'll be visiting the Monroe family. Let's get started. Hi, I'm Deborah Tannen of the show Let's Go Tannen with Deborah Tannen. Is your mom home?
Mom, there's another Jehovah's Witness at the door. Can I help you? I thought my husband told you we were Scientologists.
Oh, no, ma'am. We're not here for that. As you know, I'm Deborah Tannen of Let's Go Tannen with Deborah Tannen and author of the possible bestseller You're Wearing That by Deborah Tannen. We're here today to interview your family.
I'm sorry. Who are you?
I'm Deborah Tannen of Let's Go Tannen.
No. I got that. What the hell are you doing here?
Oh my God, Deborah Tannen from Let's Go Tannen with Deborah Tannen. You guys made it. Please come in. Don't mind my mother.
Don't mind if I do.
Jackie, what's going on here?
I told you about this a few weeks ago. Deborah Tannen is here to sort out our issues.
Issues? We don't have any issues.
Yes, we do. Chapter 6 behavior.
Everyone in this family is fine.
This right here is a perfect example of how dysfunctional our family really is. I say something and you only hear what you want to hear.
This is gonna be good.
You brought this to this house and expected it to sit well with me? If you thought we were dysfunctional before, wait until this leaves and I get my hands on you. Or better yet, wait till your father finds out.
Oh my God. I can't believe that Deborah Tannen from Let's Go Tannen with Deborah Tannen is in my house. Jackie, you really outdid yourself. How did you pull this off?
Thanks, Daddy.
Wow.
We're rolling.
Oh, and we're back. Sorry, folks, we were having some technical difficulties. Let's recap, shall we? I, Deborah Tannen, am sitting with the Monroe family with Jack, Jackie, and Tina, and...
Marilyn.
Really? Marilyn Monroe? Really?
You.
As I was saying, we're here with the Monroe family trying to figure out what has divided this family. What went wrong in this household? Let's begin with Jackie. Tell us, Jackie, what do you think has caused this chasm in your relationships?
Well, my biggest thing is my mom doesn't really seem to know me. Like last year on my birthday.
Jackie, are you ready for your gift?
About time.
What is it?
Close your eyes. Okay, open them.
Surprise, it's Hello Kitty. I know how much you love her.
What? No, I don't.
Yes, you do. I remember when your whole room was filled with that damn cat. We couldn't get you to wear anything else.
Yeah, like a million years ago. I can't believe that's what you got me for my sweet 16.
And how did that make you feel?
I just couldn't believe how little she knew about me. I mean, how does someone who sees me every day not know me?
Really, Tina? Hello, Kitty?
I'm sorry. I really thought I hit the nail on the head with birthday gifts that year.
Well, in her defense, she did get me this mug, so cheers to that.
You see? And I remember you cried for like 5 days when you missed a Hello Kitty float at the parade.
I was 12. I grew up, you know.
Well, this makes perfect sense to me. This is what I refer to as She Sees the Old Me in Chapter 9 of my book, You're Wearing That, by me, Deborah Tannen. It seems to me that your mother doesn't want you to change. She remembers you as a young child when you once looked up to her as your hero.
Wow, you're so smart.
Oh, thank you. But as I was saying, it seems to me your mother simply wants to nurture you.
Nurturing her? Really?
I am always trying. Don't you remember? Trying to help.
I wasn't even cold, and your blanket made me sick, so thanks for being nurturing. Good job, Mom.
Well, it looks like you're both wrong.
I knew it.
Well, according to this, it's hard for daughters to understand that a mother's nature is the need to protect them, and it's hard for mothers to understand that their expression of concern can undermine their daughter's confidence and seem like criticism rather than caring. Wow, this is really good. Who wrote this? Oh yeah, me, Deborah Tannen.
I swear, if you say your name
Mom,
one more time.
Mom, I don't know who to go out with, Edward or Jacob. They're both asking me, but I don't know who to say yes to.
I thought you stopped talking to Edward.
What? How do you know that?
Your mother just texted me.
Jack, you weren't supposed to say anything.
What? Oh, wait. I just got that. Whoops.
Mom, you always do this to me.
Why are you blaming me? It's your father who announced it to the world. For some reason, you two always like making me into the villain. Remember last year when...
Mom, Dad said I will never marry a sane man.
Don't worry, sweetie. I'm sure he's just a bit upset you dress like that.
Dress? What's that supposed to mean?
You know, like you're going to a funeral.
This is so typical of you, Mom. Way to bring down my creativity. I can't believe you agree with him. I come here for advice and this is what you tell me? You might as well just spit in my face, set me on fire, and throw me into an abyss of eternal darkness.
What an emotional lightning rod.
What the f*** did you just call me, b***?
No. You're misunderstanding me. In chapter 6 of my book, You're Wearing That by Deborah Tannen, I refer to this situation as the emotional lightning rod. Basically, you pick on your mom because she's an easy target. You're intimidated by your father, so you lash out on her because she's less likely to retaliate. I'll get it. Yes?
Hello there. Would you be interested to learn about the path to the Eternal Kingdom?
Why, yes, I would.
Well, as a Jehovah's Witness, we...
Sit back down. We're all devout Scientologists here.
You're right. I hate when strangers show up unannounced anyways. Now, where were we? Yes. Now we can move on to the final part of our show. Tina, will you please? This is the part of the show that I like to refer to as message versus meta-message with special guest referee Deborah Tannen.
What?
Shh, let her finish.
Thanks, Jack. As I was saying, message versus meta-message with special guest referee Deborah Tannen is the battle between what a parent says and what their child heard. This battle usually begins and ends with miscommunication. Take, for example, the story in the letter you wrote to me, Jackie, which provided the title of my book.
You're not wearing that, are you?
What's wrong with it?
I don't know. I just thought you wanted to make a good impression.
Why do you always have something negative to say?
I'm not saying anything negative. I just thought you wanted to wear something else.
As you see, it may appear harmless to Tina, but here's what Jackie heard.
You're not wearing that, are you?
What's wrong with it?
I don't know where to start. First off, you look like a whore. Talk about not knowing how to be discreet. So, it's been a while. Big deal. Make them work for it. Second of all, you look cheap. I don't know.
Oh, snap, Tina. I can't believe you went there. Oh.
Neither can I, Jack. Neither can I. But, you see, that's where the battle of message versus a meta-message comes in. From Jackie's perspective, everything her mother says and does has two levels of meaning. This is something we can all agree on. Everything we say usually has a double meaning.
That's brilliant.
I promise you, it's all in my book, which you can buy today for 3 payments of $14.99. All terms of agreement apply. No shipping for Hawaii, Alaska, and Ohio.
I'll take 3. We're gonna fix this family if it's the last thing we do. You ladies are gonna start taking responsibility for your actions.
You're not so innocent either, Dad. Mom has her issues, but you take the cake.
Hello?
Dad, Jackie's sick.
Well, give her some medicine.
I already tried that. She's throwing up all over the place.
Take her to the doctor.
How can I do that? We have no way of getting there.
Look, your mom has the car. I'm sorry, there's nothing I can do.
I needed you that day, Dad, and so did Jackie.
I just don't see how I could have helped. I was all the way in the city and I had no car. By the time I came back, I would have not made a difference.
Stop right there, Jack. Let me explain this to the audience. As you know, men and women are different.
No, Sherlock, you figured that one all on your own.
As I was saying, men are indifferent. When it comes to problems and issues, they only care about the solution and consider everything else, including feelings and emotions, irrelevant. If they cannot fix a problem, they prefer not to get involved. Women, on the other hand, are much more emotional. If you would have called your mother, she would have shown concern and compassion, something you can't expect from a man.
That's not true. What about when... Oh, no flashback? Okay, I guess I'll tell my story. What about when I asked if I should get back with my boyfriend and all she ever said was, I don't know, Jackie. Why don't you ask your sister?
That doesn't even sound like me. And that's not fair. I never liked that kid anyway. And I was sick. How come when a man does it, it's in his genetic makeup, but when I do it, I'm a b-?
You could say that again. What a b- thing to do. Your daughter comes to you for advice and you just brush her off? I don't think there's anything in here about bad parenting. Let's face it, you're just a bad mama. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it has been quite the exciting evening, hasn't it? As you can see, some questions simply have no answers.
My property, you crazy or I come kick your again.
And on that note, I'd like to thank you all for tuning in and watching Let's Go Tannin with Deborah Tannen, brought to you by Deborah Tannen's Tannin Lotion. Please tune in next week while I visit the Manson family. I guarantee it'll be a killer show. Signing off, I'm Deborah Tannen.
The same, no matter time, no place. They don't understand that us kids are going to make some mistakes. So to you other kids all across the land, there's no need to argue. Parents just don't understand.